I was looking for a fun project to put my Raspberry Pis to work, and I came across the Mysterium Node. In this tutorial, I'm going to quickly show you how to install Mysterium on your Raspberry Pi and some of my thoughts on this decentralized web application. All links will be down in the description. First, you want to go to Mysterium Node website and create an account. Click Get Started if you don't have an account. Click on Create an Account, fill out the details, and keep the web page open. You will need this later for the API key. To install, I'll be following the basic Raspberry Pi guide provided by Mysterium. Make sure your Raspberry Pi is supported so there are no compatibility issues. To flash the file, we're going to download the mystberry.zip file. We're then going to use Ballinger Etcher to write the image to our Raspberry Pi. You can also use other alternatives like Rufus, Win32 Disk Imager, and Universal USB Installer. I prefer to use the portable version of Ballinger Etcher. Once downloaded, open Ballinger Etcher and click Flash from File. Select the MYSTberry file, then select the correct SD card slot to write to. This will delete all information on that SD card, so make sure you pick the correct one. Then click on Flash to write the zip file onto the SD card. Depending on the SD card and your computer speed, this may take around 10 minutes. I'll fast forward the video to the spot when it completes. Once it completes, remove the SD card and place it into your Raspberry Pi. Next, we're going to get the Raspberry Pi ready for the first boot. You need to ask yourself a question here. Can I find the IP address of my Raspberry Pi once it's connected to the router? I'm using an app called Fing, which shows me everything connected to the router. You can also connect to your router and search under LAN for all connected devices. If this is too hard, I would suggest connecting a monitor to the first boot so you can find your IP address to connect to. I've chosen to connect my Pi headless without a monitor, so I'm now going to power the Pi and wait a few minutes for the first boot. After a few minutes have passed, open a new web browser and enter your IP address for the Raspberry Pi. Example, mine is 192.168.0.97 and attach the colon 4449 to the end of it. The Mysterium Node UI should open. When you see the Welcome Node Runner message, click the Start Node Setup to begin the installation. The first step is to create a strong, hard-to-guess password for your node. Then click on Claim This Node. You can find your API key from the Accounts page when you first signed up to Mysterium. Copy and paste your personal API key into the API key section. Then press Save and Continue. That's it. You have now installed and configured a Mysterium node on the Raspberry Pi. I've been testing this for the past 3 weeks. This is my live account. I'm just going to go through quickly the menu options and some of the sections. Total MYST I've earned on the Pi. The uptime on this Pi. Total gigabytes transferred to the network. How many sessions or customers connecting, and how many unique sessions. And this is a new section where money has not settled yet. I believe when you get 5 MYST, it will automatically move to your balance where you can withdraw to your wallet. There are always fees, so keep an eye on this. The latest sessions show who has been connecting. I currently have 2 users connected to the Pi. The last 30 days report will show total earnings, sessions, and data in a nice graph format. This section here will show your node status if it's online. Accepting connections will show if there are any issues with your router and porting traffic. This section is how much you get paid. You get 2 payments, a price per hour that your Raspberry Pi is online, and MYST paid for each gigabyte that's transferred. Global server settings, I've disabled it so all traffic is allowed. You can enable it to have only safe Mysterium partner traffic, which I believe is only used for streaming services. But when I tried this option, there were no connections for days, and I think I made around 5 cents in 3 days. I'm guessing if you live in the US, it will be a better option, but not from Australia or other countries. And this switch is to limit bandwidth, which I don't, since this network I'm using has a lot of bandwidth to use. This section shows all previous connections and current live sessions. I think the Netherlands account may be Mysterium developers checking if the network is up, because they never pay anything. They seem to ping the network. The settings section is very important. You can find your API key. Make sure to keep that a secret. Don't forget to also add your wallet to withdraw funds. The address needs to be ERC20 compatible wallet or a MYST compatible exchange. I'm using Trust Wallet, so I've added my address here. I don't know much about the advanced settings, so I've left everything as default. Your identity and payment channel is provided from the installation. And finally, your wallet and transaction history. When you withdraw and I believe settle, which I may be wrong on that, the transactions are viewed here. This has changed recently, but it keeps track of your funds and transaction IDs. So what have I learned? This is a fun project if you have a spare Raspberry Pi floating around. Easy to set up and with no maintenance. It even updates itself. I have two currently running on two different ISPs. In Australia, to run a Raspberry Pi for a year costs around $10 to $15 in electricity. So far, I've made around $15 USD in 45 days, so there is definitely a return on your investment. But there are a couple of things you need to know. One, your IP address is public. I have a private network, so it's not an issue, but if you had public dedicated IP address, then you may not want other users using it for their own internet surfing. Two, I don't like the fact that other users can be surfing inappropriate site. Yes, you're only rerouting traffic, but that sits uneasily with me. I also reroute internal traffic with Wireshark, which is a more advanced option inside. Three, some ISPs in countries may not like you selling your traffic off, so check your terms and conditions with your ISP. Also, make sure you have an unlimited traffic and bandwidth plan to cover all the downloading. Four, when withdrawing money, use the Polynet network. The fees are extremely low. There is no point in using Ethereum exchange because the fees are completely ridiculous. If you have any other projects you can recommend for the Pi, let me know and I'll give it a shot. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.